Okay, we are going to do algebra unit 1.5, page 21. So every week I will touch on a little bit. Today's focus is on simplify and expand. What do you understand by the word simplify and expand? Yes, simplify. Don't tell me yes, simplify. What do you see when you need to simplify? I keep using this word yes, last year. Mid year also do, final year also do. Yes, thank you. We move the bracket. What else? After you remove the bracket, what must you do? Basically, yeah, simplify. So basically, you need to group all the like terms. That's the main idea behind simplify and expand. So I'm going to use four examples to show you the meaning of simplify and expand. Problem is correct. We need to remove the bracket. Are there any brackets in example one? So, if I need to remove the bracket, what must I do to remove the bracket? Multiply, okay? So multiply means, technically, I call this one method. Technically, last year, what method did I say? The rainbow method. But must be very careful, I tell you. They always like to give minus. If you give minus, what happens to the sign inside the bracket? It will change. So this is the one thing I want you to be very focused on. This thing need to do anything? Don't need. I just copy. Negative 2 multiplied by positive 6. Can you see what will we get? Negative 12. Again, negative 2 rainbow expansion multiplied by negative 2x. Asking what will we get? Positive? That's all? There's an x, positive 4x. Okay, after you remove the bracket, what is this? I need to group the like terms. What's the meaning of like terms? Group the numbers together. Where are the numbers? 5 and negative 12, right? Press the calculator. 5 minus 12. What do you get? Negative 7. These are like terms because they are numbers. Other than numbers, what other terms do we have? We have those terms in x, right? So these are terms in x. 3x plus 4x, what do you get? 7x. I'm going to show you magic, Look, don't blink, Some of you may give me this answer. Teacher, there's a 7 here, there's a 7 here. Then I take out the 7. Then this is my answer. Is this answer correct? This answer is not wrong, but is it appropriate? Yatana, why no? Thank you. The main objective of simplify and expand is to remove the bracket. Don't go and put in bracket. If I want you to put in bracket, what will be the question called? No, not solve. Yes, factorize. Unless this question says factorize, then you put it in bracket. If not, don't. Right? Don't put it in bracket. Then we are done. This is the difficult one. This one can do? I think so. Come, Habira, come and do. Just show me. Same thing. I don't want the bracket. Thank you. multiplied by x, Malcolm, what do we get? 2x multiplied by x squared. 2 times 1, this is the 1. 2 times 1 give you? 2x squared, not 3x. Okay, 2x times negative 3. Negative 6x. Okay, I'm done for the first one. Next, Daniel, second one. Positive 1 times x. Positive 1 times negative 3. Is this the final answer? Why isn't this the final answer? There is a pair of like terms. There is an x here, there is an x here. So I need to simplify further. There's no x squared, I continue to write the x squared. There is a term in x, there's a term in x. Negative 6x plus x, what do we get? Minus 7x, is the problem correct? Negative 5x. Then the number, just continue to write the number. Alright? Last example for the day. Teacher, just now you say remove the bracket. This question is also simplified. Are there any brackets? There are. Heaven. Later, see. How many terms are there over here? There are 2 terms. The meaning of simplify means I don't want 2 terms. I want a single term. The idea of having a single term means what must we do? Make same denominator, you are correct. Okay, if I want to make the same common denominator, Atika, the first fraction must multiply by what? Okay, so I multiply by 3 and multiply by 2. Second fraction, I need to multiply by what? 5. So I multiply by 5, I multiply by 5. But I don't want you to write like that. Look carefully, I better put a bracket. Because there are 2 terms over here. Both terms must be multiplied by 5. Okay? I'm going to write everything out. 3 times 5 or 5 times 3. What do we get? 15. Please be careful. You see, the bracket will come now. 3 times 8. What do we get? 3. Minus, please put minus, put a 5, continue to write the bracket. You see, there is still a bracket. I do not want the bracket. So the idea is to simplify, remove the bracket and group the like terms. So it's still the same. You told me change to common denominator, I did it. After that, I need to remove the bracket. How do I remove the bracket? Rainbow expansion. Alright, rainbow expansion. So Felix, negative 5 times 8.
Negative 5. Very good.
Negative 5 times negative 1. Positive 5. Is this answer good enough? Why not? How to simplify? 3a minus 5a are like terms, you need to put them together, you will get? Right? So all these examples will show you simplify the expression. Felix, stop.